We want to determine the limit as x approaches 3 of the rational function. We want to find this limit analytically, and then we'll verify it graphically. For a rational function, if the function is defined at x equals 3, we can find this limit by performing direct substitution. But notice if we substitute 3 for x, we would have 9 plus 6, which is 15, minus 15, which is 0, so we'd have division by 0. So if we want to find this limit by performing direct substitution, we'll have to try to first simplify this rational function. So we're going to start by factoring the numerator and denominator. So we'll have the limit as x approaches positive 3. The numerator has a common factor of 4. If we factor 4 out, we're left with the quantity x minus 3. And then the denominator will also factor into two binomial factors. The factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of negative 15 that add to positive 2 are positive 5 and negative 3. Notice in factored form, we have a common factor of x minus 3 between the numerator and denominator. Graphically, this means our function would have a hole at x equals positive 3, but this hole does not affect our limit, which means we can go ahead and simplify out this common factor, which leaves us with the function 4 divided by the quantity x plus 5. And we can use this simplified function to determine our limit. So now we have the limit as x approaches positive 3 of 4 divided by the quantity x plus 5. Notice the simplified function is defined at x equals 3, so we can determine this limit by performing direct substitution. We would have 4 divided by 3 plus 5, which is 8. 4 eighths simplifies to 1 half. So this would be our limit, but let's also verify this graphically. Remember, if we graph the original function, it'll be the same as the function f of x equals 4 divided by the quantity x plus 5, except we'll have a hole at x equals positive 3. So here's the graph of the original function. Here's the hole we referred to at x equals positive 3. Notice how the graph also has a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 5, which doesn't affect our limit because we're approaching positive 3. As we approach positive 3 from the left and from the right, notice how the function values are approaching positive 1 half, which does verify our limit. So notice how even though the function will never equal 1 half because it's undefined at x equals 3, the limit is still equal to 1 half. I hope you found this helpful.